Number 9. Whale sharks are sharks and not whales. Whales are defined as aquatic, placental marine mammals, of which the whale shark is not. Nevertheless, the whale shark has been branded as a whale by virtue of its massive size. As a matter of fact, the whale shark is the largest fish in the ocean. As the largest non-cetacean animal in the world, whale sharks can weigh up to 47,400 pounds. That's more than the weight of a bus, which can weigh as much as 40,000 pounds. They also can be as long as 40 feet in length, which is about the length of a standard city bus. Throughout history, there have been reports of human encounters with super massive whale sharks. In 1915, Hugh M. Smith, an American ichthyologist, described an animal captured in a bamboo fish trap off the coast of Thailand. Although no official measurements were taken, it is estimated that the creature, a whale shark, weighed 86,000 pounds and was as long as 60 feet. There may be even more massive specimens deep beneath the ocean. Number 8. Whale sharks are filter feeders, meaning that they feed by straining suspending matter and food particles out of the water, typically bypassing the water through a specialized feeding structure. The whale shark is one of the only three known sharks which are filter feeders. Others include the megamouth shark and the basking shark. When it comes to filter feeders, there are two types: active feeders and passive feeders. The whale shark is an active feeder, meaning that it targets active concentrations of plankton or fish. As for passive feeders, such as the megamouth shark, they usually pick up whatever they can get while they swim. Whale sharks typically prefer food like plankton, krill, fish eggs, red crab larvae, and small fish and squid. While active feeding, it uses active suction, opening and closing its mouth in quick succession so as to suck in large volumes of water, which are expelled by the gills. The food is filtered by modified gill rakers and subsequently digested. Number 7. Whale sharks are very slow swimmers. Whale sharks move at speeds no faster than 3 miles per hour. Compare this to the blue whale, which can move as fast as 30 miles per hour, and the bottlenose dolphin, which can be as fast as 18 miles per hour. This slow rate of movement helps the whale sharks feed, but then again, it also makes them susceptible to attacks from predators such as the blue marlin and the blue shark. In spite of the whale shark's low rate of swimming, it can migrate across extremely large distances. In fact, it can travel 8,000 miles or more in 3 whole years. Like most other animals, they migrate during the winter months to warmer waters so as to find food. They generally prefer waters of a temperature around 70 degrees Fahrenheit. Whale sharks inhabit all tropical and warm temperate seas. They can be found in both coastal and oceanic habitats. They have also been known to dive to depths of 6,200 feet. And importantly, they exist in two distinct populations. There's the Atlantic subpopulation and the Indo-Pacific subpopulation. The latter holds 75% of all whale sharks. Number 6. Female whale sharks can give birth to 300 young at once. However, given that these whale sharks are ovoviviparous, the actual process of fertilization, gestation, and birth is different from that of mammals. Being ovoviviparous, female members of the species lay eggs, and fertilization takes place internally. After fertilization, the female also carries the eggs inside them for the entire period of gestation. When the eggs are ready, they hatch internally, and so the mothers give birth to live young. A single mating session can result in the birth of a large number of young. However, these births may occur at different intervals and not all at once. Young whale sharks are known as pups and can be born 300 at a time. Out of these 300, not all of them get the chance to grow to maturity. Many of them are picked off by the aforementioned predators, the blue marlin and the blue shark. It doesn't help that the mother leaves the young to fend for themselves. Only about 10% of whale shark pups survive to adulthood. Number 5. Whale sharks have dotted spots on their bodies. This allows divers, marine biologists, and fishermen to easily identify them. These spots aren't just there for aesthetics. Much like human fingerprints, the pattern of these spots is different for different whale sharks and therefore serves as a unique means of identification. By taking pictures of these spots, researchers are able to keep up with the whale sharks over long periods of time and over long distances. This is how scientific facts like their reproductive cycles, migratory habits, and travel speeds were determined. A common misconception is that these spots are used to calculate their ages. However, this is not the case. Other than just spots, some whale sharks have stripes on their bodies as well. Their skin can be as much as 6 inches thick and can be very hard and rough to the touch. In addition to this, the whale shark has 3 prominent ridges along its sides, which start above and behind the head and end at the caudal peduncle. Number 4. Whale sharks are an endangered species. This classification arises due to the relentless hunting of these creatures by fisheries. Oil spills have also cut down on their population numbers. Even though mothers give birth to a lot of young, the fact that only 10% of these birthed young live to adulthood means that these population figures are likely to stay low until the threats to these creatures are eliminated completely. One of the seemingly innocuous activities humans partake in, which affects these creatures' population numbers, is ecotourism. Whale sharks are quite popular, so they attract large numbers of ecotourists. These ecotourists time the season feeding aggregations of these creatures, which happen in and around locations like Western Australia, the Galapagos Islands, Mexico, Mozambique, the Philippines, Seychelles, China, Qatar, and India. In fact, in 2011, about 400 whale sharks gathered off the Yucatan coast. It is the largest ever gathering of these creatures ever recorded. Since they gather to feed, the presence of ecotourists could cause disruption, making them lose out on important nourishment. Number 3. Whale sharks are quite friendly. In general, sharks aren't known for being friendly. However, the whale shark forms an exception. Whale sharks are known to be quite friendly. They don't harm divers or fishermen at all. Sometimes they even allow certain humans to ride on their backs. In fact, in August 2020, an Arab man went viral when he posted a video of himself riding a whale shark. The man, known as Abu Badi, performed the feat in the ocean of Yanbu, Saudi Arabia, while his friends followed behind in a boat and recorded the whole thing. The video generated several reactions of awe. However, there were those who expressed their disapproval, as riding a whale shark could harm them, and being endangered, the concern was extra serious. Whale sharks are considered so harmless that humans are actually a way bigger danger to them than they are to humans. As such, conservation groups urgently express the need for ecotourists and divers to avoid injuring these creatures. There have also been efforts to free them from giant aquariums where they are held in captivity. Number 2. Whale sharks live quite long. They live between 80 to 150 years. Growth rates are determined using vertebrae growth bands. Though these bands were thought to form biannually, researchers revealed they form every year, giving credibility to age estimates of these creatures. Whale sharks exhibit some measure of sexual dimorphism. Although males grow faster than females, males end up at a smaller maximum size than females do. Both genders also reach sexual maturity quite late in life. Males typically tend to reach sexual maturity at about 25 years old. Although we've established that these creatures don't take care of their young, they still have an interesting way of trying to give them the best chances of survival. After mating, females typically store sperm from the males and, at certain time intervals, fertilizes the eggs on her own. And so, unlike other species which have fixed periods of fertilization, gestation, and birth, the female whale shark could be at various stages of each of these activities at a given time. Number 1. Their mouths are their most important organs. The whale shark's mouth is nothing to write off either. Given that they are filter feeders, their mouths are very large so as to facilitate this behavior. A 40-foot whale shark was once reported to have a mouth size of 5 feet across. Unlike most other sharks, the whale shark also has its mouth at the front of its head rather than the underside of its head. Whale shark mouths can contain as many as 300 to 350 rows of teeth. They usually have a total of about 3,000 teeth. Each of these teeth is tiny and less than 1 inch long. But again, as filter feeders, they don't use these teeth to eat. As a matter of fact, they can process about 6,000 liters of water every hour. They expel a lot through their gills, only keeping solid organisms smaller than about 2 centimeters in diameter. Did you ever swim with or see whale sharks? Let us know in the comments section below.